This, of course, means I won't be making anything till 3-drop. No mulligans. Hide the ugly Momir, have the pretty Momir up. And click my mountain until he goes past the stop on my upkeep. He's giving some good consideration to whether to mulligan that hand. It must not have enough basic land types. I have all 5. If I wanted turn 5 Wooburg, I could have it. We'll see if the opponent can go 3 games in a row with a early mana producer. No creature on turn 2. Interesting. Ooh, first strike. Regeneration. These are kind of useful. Let's see what he gets. Uh-oh. My guy can't block this turn. So this is another situation where I'm going to make my drop before deciding whether to attack or not. No, never mind. I'm going to attack first. And then I'm going to play Island here. I think I'll go Island, Mountain, Plains, Forest. Clearly. Rabbit-a-rabbit-a, Shaman. Alright, he's got a Riptide Director. I am not going to block. This time I will make my creature before attacking. Okay. Oh, you got a 4/4, that's kind of annoying. And I will use the ability. Now the question is, do I attack with the Scobs also? And I might as well. I'm willing to trade my 4/4 for his 4/4 here. Oh, but this is really bad. I should have, Oh, that's really bad. Oh, wow. That would be an interesting block. Wow, just no blocks? Alright. So I punted and he punted back, basically. I think he thought that it was, that undying, like, it would actually undie and come back. So I think I can take advantage of that in future turns. Because that's kind of the only way that that play makes any sense on his side. Three, five. But that's so big. hurry to play the forest, so I might as well play swamp first. Alright, so I guess worst case scenario is that this still trades for his 4-4. I don't think I attack with this, because I'd be trading it for a 3-5, which probably isn't worth it. Oh, so I get to trade this for his 3-5 instead, or what is he doing? He's chump blocking, because he still thinks it's going to undie. This is awesome. Now I get to just bash with a lot of stuff. I think. Oh, wow. Hi, Vorinclex. Yeah, let's give this +2/+0. We're definitely attacking with that, because he still seems really scared of it. Yeah, and I think we just attack with all of these things. Because that makes it more likely that I'm able to attack with, like, Sanguine Guard or Vorinclex next turn. Okay, so Machine's blocking Scobs. He's double blocking Barktooth and he's letting through Paleoloth, or... No. What? What? Okay. Those were not the blocks I expected. If I'm being honest. So now he needs to hit something awesome to stop Vorinclex, and he needs more luck than that. Don't care about the order of these. That guy's really insane. We've seen him a lot this time. Okay, well, that'll help. Now I have to make a 12 instead of the, Oh, okay. Or he could scoop. Alrighty, so I managed to win that one. We found out that Undying does not actually work in Momir. And, yeah, that was very special. I will hope to have similar good luck and get some more Vorinclexes next round. Or maybe, like, Celestial Force. The guy's my favorite card ever. It just sits there, it's impossible to kill, it makes the game go intensely long. It's ridiculous. That'll be fun. I think it's called Celestial Force. Anyway, round 3 coming up.